Hi, let's talk about the branches off of the arch of the aorta. The arch of the aorta is supplied by the ascending aorta. So the ascending aorta moves into the arch of the aorta, and then it is continuous with the descending aorta. So let's focus on the branches from the arch. The first major branch is the brachiocephalic artery. Brachio, arm, cephalic, head. And there are two branches to the brachiocephalic artery. There is the right subclavian artery. That right subclavian artery is heading out through the root of the neck and will transform itself into the axillary artery and then into the brachial artery. And we'll discuss that later. And then there is the right common carotid artery. That right common carotid artery is going to ascend the neck within the carotid sheath. The carotid sheath is going to have major contents of that common carotid artery, internal jugular vein, and vagus nerve, as well as contributions from the glossopharyngeal nerve and the accessory nerve at the top of the sheath. And in some cases, we might also see ansa cervicalis embedded within that sheath. But needless to say, that common carotid artery is heading up towards the superior portion of the neck, where it's going to bifurcate into the internal and external carotid arteries to be discussed. The next major branch off of the aortic arch is the left common carotid artery, which will have typically all of the same branches as the right common carotid artery. And then finally, the left subclavian artery, which is going to have all of the same branches as the right subclavian artery. So, as you notice, there are right and left subclavian arteries and right and left common carotid arteries. The only difference in terms of the arch of the aorta is that on the right side, there is this brachiocephalic trunk. Now let's take a look at that common carotid artery. So here we have the contents of the carotid sheath all dissected out. There is the internal jugular vein. There is cranial nerve 10, the vagus nerve, and some of its branches descending down within the sheath. And here is the common carotid artery. And we can see that common carotid artery bifurcating into an external carotid artery and an internal carotid artery. And that internal carotid artery is more posteriorly oriented, and the external carotid artery is more anteriorly oriented. And so that external carotid artery is going to supply elements of the neck with blood, elements of the face with blood, elements of the sublingual space, elements of the infratemporal fossa with blood, elements of the skull with blood. Whereas the internal carotid artery has no branches in the neck. It ascends up, but before it does so, at its origin, there's a dilation known as the carotid sinus. So let's pay attention to the image here. This is a posterior view of the bifurcation of the common carotid artery. There is the external carotid. There is the internal carotid, and we can see that dilation of the internal carotid there, known as the carotid sinus. And within the walls of the carotid sinus, we have specialized stretch receptors or baroreceptors that give feedback to the central nervous system with respect to blood pressure up to the brain. And there's also an association with this region known as the carotid body, which is a chemosensor for the blood that's traveling up into the internal carotid. Most of the donors at this age lack a carotid body. It is atrophied at this point. And so this isn't something that we'll be able to see on this particular specimen. But the internal carotid artery ascends It enters into the skull through the carotid canal, which is an osseous pathway through the temporal bone, and it's going to give rise to branches within the cranial cavity, things like the middle cerebral artery, the anterior cerebral artery, the posterior communicating branch, which can meet branches of the vertebral artery coming from the subclavian to form the cerebral arterial circle of Willis. And it also produces the ophthalmic artery, which runs through the orbit and even exits branches from the orbit to serve the superior portion of the face with blood as well. Thank you very much for your time.